All right, welcome everybody. More universe. Brain not working. More universe mode. Good. I got that out. The tag team champions going up against... What is going on? It was freezing there for a minute. What is this? Back up. Come on, Xbox. I know it's warm in here. Come on. You stay good. Okay. We have the tag team champions, Kofi and R-Truth, going up against Primo and Epico. It's very strange behavior exhibited by my Xbox. Not sure what's going on. If it goes down, I don't know what I'm going to do. You have to keep going, Xbox. You must. For everyone, for all our sakes. It's taking quite a while to load. Ugh. I'm so nervous. Okay, here we go. Los Angeles, California. Here come the tag team champions. Not even an entrance for these two. Unbelievable. So generic. Regardless, they are the tag team champions. Here come Primo and Epico. They have their own entrance. Hint, hint. Here we go. I think we have to be the tag team champions because I want to take Primo and Epico out of the number one contendership. So we're going to isolate Primo here. We're just going to utilize tag team maneuvers and take Primo out. Epico won't be a factor. Should be a pretty easy win for us, I think. Oh man, I don't really like that move, but here we go. Tagging in. Kofi on his way in. Going for a quick pin. Is he going to get it? No, of course not. Gotta do more. Much more. And Primo getting in an armbar. I don't think so, buddy. Throwing him off the ropes. Oh, and a reversal into a Hurricane Rana. Primo could have tagged out, but he chose not to. His mistake. Oh, headbutt. Primo getting a little nippy here. I don't want him to tag out to Epico. And R-Truth kind of bending the rules here. Oh, we take out R-Truth. I'm sorry, R-Truth.
Oh my gosh.
No.
I don't believe the destruction we're seeing. This guy's just going from one painful move to another. Okay, the ref starts to count.
Oh, there we go. That's the arm drag you wanted.
Oh,
no. Primo coming back. Yep, over the ropes. Come on, get up. Get up, buddy. I'm gonna get you. And we got him. Get him, R-Truth. Get him. Get him while we walk around you. Get him. We'll just let R-Truth beat him down. We'll take down Epico over here. Drop-kicked Epico. And here comes Primo coming back in. Oh! We tried to go over. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, and he missed. He missed.
Man, that was a vicious elbow drop. And we're going back between the ropes.
And we're running around again. What a crazy high-flying match here with Kofi Kingston and Primo. Oh, hitting the right hands in the corner. The uppercut. Get him. Yeah. Primo in bad shape, it seems. Yeah, look at that. Good God. How long has this match been going? 4 minutes? Yeah, it didn't seem like very long. Primo been taken out. Oh, man. R-Truth. You don't let him get the pin. No. Good job, R-Truth. Good job. Good job, R-Truth, isolating Primo. Or, yeah, Primo. Got a little confused for a minute. Boom drop coming in. Boom, boom, boom. Hits. And we take him out. We'll jump on both of them. Oh, and we miss. Amazing results. The sacrifice you must be willing to take to compete in the big leagues in the WWE. Get in here. Get in here. Come on. Come on. Not like that. Are you insane, man? Oh, and I was supposed to be R-Truth there. Damn it. R-Truth, get out of the ring. Drop kicking Primo out. We're going to go cross body. Don't do it. Don't do it. Ooh, I had to jump. I had to. Epico being an asshole. Get the hell out of here. Get the hell out of here. Come here. Come here. You want some more of me, huh? Huh? You want some more of Kofi Kingston? Do you know who I am? Do you know who I am? Get the hell out of here. Come on. I'm not done with Epico. R-Truth, get your ass over here and help me. Take them out, please. All hell is breaking loose. Primo and Epico going up against R-Truth and Kofi. R-Truth throwing him through the steps. Primo back in the ring. Oh, and a spinning heel kick. Oh, he's hunting him. He's hunting him. Get up, Primo. Get up, Primo. Oh! I'm not even sure what that was. Oh, and a reversal, Primo. We reverse it. Good. Oh, he's so close to tagging in Epico. Oh, man, so close. No, 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 no. Don't. Yeah, Epico. No! No! Oh, they do the hot tag. Here comes Epico. Taking down Kofi. Taking down R-Truth. Alright. Come on, do your finisher, you dummy. Oh! We'll take out his leg so he's on the ground. We'll do the boom drop on his ass. Boom, 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 boom drop connecting. Maybe not getting all of it there. And a reversal. What a kick that was. Another stiff kick. Monkey flip. We need to hurt his head. Oh my gosh. Oh, and he. Oh, shoot. Did we just reverse it again? Did we get our finisher back? No. Oh, man. Oh, top leg drop misses. No, don't do this. Don't do this, Epico. Oh, we reverse into a roll-up. R-Truth. Ugh. No. No. Oh. And a monkey flip. And R-Truth. Gonna take out. Take him out. What are you doing? Big cross body. Taking him down. One. No. R-Truth. Primo battling. Big monkey flip from the corner. The hell. Come here. Come here. Oh. Oh, man, what is he doing? Is he planning to go through the... Oh! Oh! Through the chair. Through the chair. Oh, my goodness. This match. This match is something else. Get him up there. Oh! And Kofi Kingston taking him out. R-Truth is floating. More Harry Potter spells. Wingardium Leviosa. And I can't get back in the ring. Okay, there we go. There we go, taking him out. What a crazy match. R-Truth is stuck. R-Truth is stuck. Oh, no. There we go. We fixed R-Truth. Get in there. Primo and Epico being taken out. What a crazy first match. And a monkey flip right in the middle of the ring. Kofi Kingston. Come on. Get it. Get it. Did we get it? Oh. Oh, and he reverses. Come on, I just want to do the boom drop now. Oh, come on, jump on me. You missed, you jackass. Get him. Boom drop. Boom. 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 Connecting. Get up. Boom. 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 Trouble in paradise. Connect. Going for the pin. Come on, ref. Get out of the ring. One, two, three, it is over. The tag team champions win the match. Wow. Kofi Kingston doing all the work, but jeez. I was worried. I was K-Quick over there. That was R-Truth right there. K-Quick, yeah. 10 years ago, maybe. Kofi Kingston. Getting arm drug. Hitting the trouble in paradise on Epico. R-Truth taking care of Primo. We get the 1-2-3. And that is it. Is there going to be a moment here? No, generic win. Generic win for the champions. Moving right along to the Divas. Tonight's Divas, we've got Karma going one-on-one against Eve. Wonder Woman versus Big Bad Karma. Who is going to win? This is going to be very interesting. I want to just watch it, but I think the video will run too long. Let's skip the entrances and we'll watch it. I don't think Eve has any chance at all of winning this match. We're just going to watch it. Here we go. Remember what's at stake here. Let's go, Karma. Come on, Karma. Irish whip into the corner. Karma controlling the waist. Dodges to the side of that one. Quick thinking to avoid that. Oh, taking out the legs of Karma. I don't think. And there's the head scissors. Oh man, she's using her speed. Using that speed. I'm just nervous that Eve is going to hit a moonsault out of nowhere and pick a 1-2-3. But with Karma dominating, I'm not worried.
Karma's just too dangerous. Even when you think you have her, she does something like that.
Karma taking out the legs again of Eve.
We're seeing plenty of examples of the brutality that Karma brings to the table.
Oh, and look at that. Taking Eve down. Eve trying to fight back. Eve doesn't stand a chance. Karma is looking at the Bellas already. She's three steps ahead of Eve. Hopefully, let's see if... Oh, a moonsault. No. No. Moonsault connects. That's maybe 50% of her repertoire. Even elbow to the face of Karma. And Eve just doesn't want to get back into the ring. She's running away here. Gonna throw through the steps. No, back into the ring.
Oh my, another big elbow. Back
back into the ring now. She's looking to get out of here. Looks like we're going back inside.
Another elbow to the face. Eve spamming moves here.
And this is going to return to the ring.
Getting back in the ring.
Impact from that kick.
Karma not really putting up the offense I thought she would.
Well, look at this move, Cole. Oh, out of nowhere. A swift kick. What a body shot.
This match is just kind of crummy. Hopefully it picks up soon. Drop kick to the corner. Even the in-game announcers are just like, eh. Karma should either dominate or... It should be a faster-paced match. I think this is just a bad matchup. Also, I can't see their HUD, their heads-up display, so I don't know where in the match they are. Elbow to the drop on the back.
With a wild strike. Karma with the arm.
Karma very precise moves.
Oh, a textbook takedown.
Targeting the legs.
Give me a break. There's no need for that. Oh, and Eve Torres comes up with a huge move. My goodness.
Oh, and a kick, a running kick to take down Karma. Karma immediately getting back up. You're going to need to do a lot more, Eve. Oh, she reverses. Whipping her into... Where? Where is she going? Karma reverses. I was so confused for a minute. Karma reverses. Belly-belly suplex. Right hand. A whip into the corner. A hard whip. Oh, and she's down. Oh, and the clothesline reversed. Oh, and there. Oh, an armbar out of nowhere. Okay.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, wait. Nice reversal. What an STO.
And a splash. She doesn't go for the pin. That must mean that Eve isn't really down.
Karma makes the cover. Oh, what a painful kick. And don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, we still have what should be a tremendous main event to come. Oh, yeah! The WWE Universe is going to want to hold on tight for that one. Whoa,
and Eve, the AI, okay, this is it again. This is what the AI does. They either want to put you through a table, or they want to put you through the barrier. They never throw you into the corner for a top rope, oh my god, moment. It's always outside. It's always the barrier or the table. I just got... Oh, and here we go. Oh, no. Oh, no. Karma's going to go through the table. Oh, dear God. Oh, no. Is it? What is it going to be? A facebuster? What is this? Ew. Swinging neck breaker through the table. Oh, that didn't look good at all. But Karma is down. Eve looking to win by count out 6. Oh, no. Karma's back up. No way. Karma must be pissed. Taking down the legs again of Karma. Karma has gone through the table. The announcer's table. I have no clue how she's even still standing. Although that is a highly unimpactful move. Eve is leaving the ring. Where is she going? What is she going to do? Throw her through the barricade now? Two of them? I've never seen AI do both of them. Karma tossing Eve into the ring post, rolling her back into the ring. I think Karma's got the control in this match now.
Now back to the ring. Nice, well-placed kick to the ribs.
Oh no. Eve setting up a suplex on Karma.
Oh man.
Oh man, look at the strength.
Look at those eyes.
If I do a match between Big Show and Karma, can I break the ring? I don't think I can do a match between Big Show and Karma. But that should count, right? Karma hitting her move. Eve, down. Going for the pin. 1, 2. No. No, not over yet. Next King of the Ring, Karma. Karma King. King Karma. Queen Karma. Yeah, it would be Queen, wouldn't it? That sign doesn't make much sense. It's attitude error, crowd. They just don't know what they're doing. Oh no, I'm gonna try to make Karma tap out here. Karma not having any of it. Reversing. This match really started off slow. Hit a peak when Karma was going through the table, and it is again started out to be a little slow. And a splash in the corner. Karma hopefully gaining momentum. She looks good to me, sign in the crowd. Okay. There's a good sign. That's relevant, at least. When you're looking at the NPCs in the crowd, there's something wrong. What do we got? The One Woman Wrecking Crew. Yeah, I've seen that one. Eve tossing her back into the ring. An elbow to the face. You guessed it. On a clothesline on the outside of the ring, stretching her face with her boot. Karma reversing the takedown, an elbow to the back, and Eve, her midsection must be really tore up. There's been a lot of a finisher, a lot of moves that have attacked her. I don't think Eve is gonna win this match, based on what I've seen. And a clothesline picking her up for another clothesline. Oh, Eve flipping backwards with the torque of the clothesline. And she's just being dragged around the ring. Look at the embarrassment. Going for the pin again. 1, 2, no. Not even a 2 count. Karma cannot put Eve away. Chop block to the back of the leg. Karma down, and Eve still trying to get her to tap. Hand on the rope.
Collar and elbow tie up.
Nope, shoot. It's another sign of how you can tell that this match is almost over when that thing goes out. I don't even think I'll be able to put this. I might have to go all the way through the match card and upload this. We're up to 23 minutes. I don't think it'll work. Karma gonna get the ropes again. Her foot was on the rope.
Great reaction.
Karma back suplex connecting. Going for the pin on the back suplex. One. No. Yeah, it's not gonna work. Do something more. Karma tossing Eve into the corner. Eve reverses. Kick takedown. Oh no, here's her special, her signature move. Connecting to Karma. She is in perfect position for the nasty ass booty drop. Oh, but she's just gonna go for the pin. 1. No. Now Karma's automatically gonna get up. Should have hit your finisher. Uh-oh. I don't think Eve's got it. Oh, and Karma going for the pin. 1, 2, and 3. It hits. What? Poor Eve. She should have hit her finisher when she had the chance instead of going for the pin. Karma connecting. And getting the 1, 2, 3. Let's see if there's a moment, because that match wasn't all great. And no, just a generic happy Karma. Okay. Well, we're at 25 minutes. I say we just keep going now. What's the next match? What do we got? Jinder Mahal versus the Great Khali. Okay. I could be Jinder Mahal here and get a miracle win over Great Khali, but I have a feeling that this might be a feud. So I'm going to have Great Khali win first. Here comes Jinder Mahal, ready to take out Big Great Khali. Here he comes. As long as Great Khali is still on the roster, it means Big Show or Undertaker can break through the ring with him. So maybe we should keep him strong. I want to break through the ring, damn it. Oh, not the Undertaker. Damn it, I forgot. Not the Undertaker. As he attempts to walk to the ring. Oh, and we have Christian coming out on the side of Great Khali. I think Christian and Jinder Mahal had a match, did they not? A couple weeks ago. Or maybe it was Great Khali and Christian. I don't remember. I remember these three being involved somehow. We're going to be Great Khali. Yeah, Great Khali getting some momentum boost here. Jinder Mahal working hard and fast. Going to Great Khali. He can't even do anything to me in the corner because I'm so large. And there's Christian. What is Christian doing?
What's there to say about Khali? He's as scary as he looks.
What is that going on? That's so strange. Okay. Christian kind of being a bother. Messing about in the ring when he shouldn't be. We have our signature. We're ready to hit Jinder Mahal with the chop. Hit him. Yeah. Get him up. Get him up. I'm going to finish him. Oh, hitting Jinder Mahal. And this is very weird. Yeah. Whenever you try to use Great Khali's move, it moves at the very end, and it moves really fast, so trying to angle it towards a table, like last week, it's kind of hard. Oh! Come on. Was that even in this profile? I don't remember. I think it was Sin Cara. Yeah, I don't think it was this profile. Stepping on Jinder Mahal. Taking him down. Come on, Christian. I need some of your advice. Get up here. Get up here. What are you doing? Get up here, I said. Great Khali is a large individual. Great Khali winning that dispute. Reversal's going crazy here. And we're just pushing Jinder Mahal down. Oh, what is this? And a reversal, it had to be. It's the only thing that made sense. German suplex. Oh! Khali was not made to fly through the air. Taking him out. And we took out the ref. Get him, Christian. Get him. Christian, what are you doing? Christian? Really? Is he leaving? Christian is leaving. We took out the referee so we wouldn't have to work so hard. And we'll let Christian do most of the work. But Christian is now leaving. Oh no, another reversal. Yeah, I'm getting used to seeing it. Jinder Mahal taking Great Khali down. There we go. We reverse it. Attack that head. Knee him in the face. There we go. eye rake. Another reversal. We're just going to tap A. We won't even use the chart. Oh! And another reversal. Oh, man. I was going to go for the headbutt. We will reverse it. And a head chop. Get him. He hits. He hits. Great callie ready to take him down. Oh, look. Look at the impact. Oh! Taking him down. Jinder Mahal, I don't think he can kick out of two Kali bombs. One, two, and three. It is over. Christian being of absolutely no help whatsoever in that match. Let's see if we have a moment here. Great Khali just winning, I suppose. What do we got next? Next match, what do we got? We've had three, so we have two more. I know one of them. I just don't know the other one. Oh, that's right. The highlight match of the week. We have Godfather versus the Million Dollar Man's son, Ted DiBiase. Okay. Last week, they said that the Godfather was the champ of something. Not sure why, but here we go. We're taking a little troll on the hoe train. Here come the hoes. They ain't no divas. But they'll do. Who wants a hoe? We start the bidding off at $3,000. Who wants one of my hoes? Come on, one of you people, one of you bigwigs in the front want one. Yes, you do. What about you, sir? You look pretty lonely. What about you? No one wants one of my hoes. No one? No? Alright, maybe... Chimmel! Chimmel, do you want a hoe? Do you want a hoe? Take your pick. The one in the blue or the one in the pink? Chimmel doesn't seem interested. Very strange. Okay, here we go. Ted DiBiase. Cool theme. Not so cool character. Very... Nothing about him, really. It's impressive. He just needs a new gimmick, a new character. Maybe he could start a stable with Alex Riley and Jack Swagger. And you could call him the High School Bandits. Again, stealing from Smart Wrestling Fan, kind of. But Ted DiBiase, I think, would fit as the rich kid's son. He's also a jock, so I guess, you know, it would work out, him and Alex Riley. But Alex Riley, not in this game. Alex Riley had a one-game stint. All right, we have a highlight match here. We're going to be the Godfather, because he's so much cooler. Godfather looking to make Ted DiBiase one of his bitches.
Oh my, an explosive suplex.
You got one person who just doesn't earn money at all. He just gets it from daddy. And then you have another one who hoes out women to earn money. So you got the worst of both worlds.
If Godfather focused as much on wrestling as he does on clowning around, he'd probably be world champion.
Wow, Michael Cole. Dissing Godfather there. How dare you, Michael Cole? I was over there last week, Michael Cole. And a suplex connecting. Ted DiBiase has all the tools. He just doesn't have the it factor, the caliber of what it takes to be a good character. Oh, and he takes him down, Boston Crab. Ted DiBiase reverses.
And that's a stiff kick. Ted DiBiase goes behind. Total destruction.
Ted DiBiase back suplex. Oh, come on. Just let me get something in here. A punch. A kick.
He fails to connect.
They let me get one punch. Another back suplex. Ted DiBiase spamming moves.
Ted DiBiase into the
Oh, now I'm spamming moves. Full Nelson takedown. Right hand straight to the face. I think it was Godfather's finisher was like a pump handle type thing. So we need to work on the body of Ted DiBiase. A reversal into the ropes. Shoulder blocks. I was so convinced Batista would be back into the WWE because I thought it was a pattern. About 2 months ago, I predicted it, and I failed miserably. Batista not coming back to WWE anytime soon, I'm pretty sure. He was in last year's game with Brock Lesnar and Vader. Brock Lesnar and Vader both came back. Batista did not, unfortunately. So, you know, it was just strange, all these people coming back. Even, like, X-Pac and Road Dogg and Billy Gunn. All of them, you know, I mean, they weren't in the game last year. But they did come back, and they're in the game this year. It's just, you know, I expected a Batista return. Maybe at the Royal Rumble when he's looking for money. Who knows? Oh, no, I don't think so. I don't think he'll be in the Royal Rumble, because if indeed he's at the Royal Rumble, that means that he is going to have a good showing. And he can't just come out and have a good showing and then leave. So whoever comes back in the Royal Rumble is either going to be a legend or someone who's coming back to be embarrassed and taken out in a rivalry of some sort. And as we're clowning around, as Cole would say, Ted DiBiase getting back up. That is the longest taunt in the world. A back suplex connecting to the Godfather.
Ted DiBiase squeezing down on the head.
Reversing. Oh, and look at that face buster. A knee to the back of the skull, and his head must be hurt. No, his knee is not hurt at all. His head's not hurt at all. That's ludicrous. Oh, big back body drop by Ted DiBiase. We almost have our signature, but I don't really want to use it. Another big back body drop. Ted DiBiase working us over. There we go, a headbutt to the back of the head. There we go, now he's yellow. Get up. Get up. Oh, he attacked the leg. I wanted to attack the head. Signature missing. Get him. Get him. I want a kick to the face. We have to work on his head some more. Oh, look at that. Rear naked choke on Ted DiBiase. Get up. Okay. In the middle of the ring. Yeah, that's not going to work, is it? One, two, yeah. Not enough. Oh, another big back body drop. Ted DiBiase trying to come back. He just doesn't have the move set to do it. We'll just work on the head of the rich boy's face. There we go. Oh, and at the very last one, he reverses. Come on. And the Godfather gonna be clowning around here. Doing the ho shuffle. Ho shuffle gives you a lot. Good God, we'll do it again. Oh, hurry up. Oh, no. Atomic drop. Oh. Oh, and he's going to try to submit us. He's trying to submit us. How in the world do you think that's going to work? Oh. Running drop kick. Ted DiBiase coming back slowly. We need to take him. Oh, my God. I cannot lose to Ted DiBiase. Come on now. There we go, reverse. We attack the head. We push him down. No, I didn't want to taunt. I didn't mean to taunt. I knew I had my signature. Why did I taunt? Oh, but we do anyway. What are you going to do? Heel kick to the face. Get up. Hope training it up. This is longer than Dolph Ziggler's stupid head thing. Headstand. Go for the pin. One, two, and three. It is over. Godfather wins. I think SmackDown needs the most roster improvement. Raw's doing fine, and we're not even using. And oh, look, we might have some handshake action going on. Godfather Ted DiBiase being friends after all. That's kind of boring. I thought we could choose. I'm gonna have to. I don't understand. Next match. Now this is the big one. This is the one I've been waiting for. Last week, Daniel Bryan came out, attacked The Undertaker before his match against the Viper, weakening Undertaker just to the point where Viper, Randy Orton, the Apex Predator, could take control, hits an RKO 1-2-3, taking Undertaker off the top of the list for number one contender. So, out of these two men, who will Daniel Bryan want as the number one contender? Is he going to attack Randy Orton this week, or is he going to continue with the pattern of helping Orton take out his number one contenders for him? The Apex Predator, Randy Orton, in the main event again this week. Making his way to the ring. But he has to go up against Alberto Del Rio. Ricardo, ready to announce it. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Alberto Del Rio. No Randy Orton there, that's strange. Ricardo Rodriguez. So maybe they should always have Ricardo right there. I don't know. It's kind of weird. They need to fix Ricardo. Him and Alberto Del Rio, the same entrance since last year. No real change. Not even to the car. Not even a nice car. It's still generic car. And here we go. I think I'm going to be Randy Orton. Oh, never mind. I pressed start instead of A. We're going to watch a match. Randy Orton throwing Del Rio into the corner, taking him to the top. Oh no, a superplex to begin the match. No! Top rope DDT! Alberto Del Rio looking to claim the number one contender spot over Randy Orton. Claiming it is his destiny to be the world champion. And here comes Daniel Bryan. Daniel Bryan, the referee is nowhere in sight. I don't know where the referee is. But Randy Orton, thinking he's going to help him. Daniel Bryan takes out Randy Orton. Del Rio in prime position to win this match.
Del Rio into the headlock.
Del Rio should focus on the arms here, and he does. Focus on those arms, because he just gave you a huge boost. Last week it was Undertaker, this week it was Randy Orton.
And that series ends in deadlock. Neither one of these superstars can afford to give their opponent the upper hand.
Randy Orton's still going to fight back. Randy Orton does have a comeback. Bear in mind, he does have a comeback. And he will hit the RKO out of nowhere if possible, if need be, and take a win over Del Rio. So I want Del Rio to win, just to see if the pattern continues. But I think Randy Orton still will win this match. Randy Orton with a gut buster. Making his way back into this match. Uppercut to Del Rio. The back suplex connecting to Del Rio. Randy Orton. Uppercut to Del Rio. It's been a very physical, and another uppercut. This has been a very physical match. The referee, I don't know where he was. Maybe Ricardo was distracting him. Who knows? Oh, and a reversal. Luthez. Two right hands, three right hands to the face of Del Rio. And Randy Orton. Hearing voices in his head. The new announce table that we got set up after the first match of the night. Being destroyed again. Getting thrown into the barricade. Oh, a German suplex. So close to those steel steps. Oh, into the barricade for Orton. Oh, a chop block to the back of the leg to Del Rio. And is he going to win by count out? No, Del Rio is back up and back into the ring they go. Clothesline connecting. Going for a stomp to the face. Del Rio looking to come back. And a running clothesline takedown there. A kick to the back. Working on the Viper's midsection. Randy Orton with control. Going for a scoop slam.
And again he moves to the outside. Oh no! Those steps have to weigh over 200 pounds!
200 pounds. That's crazy.
Back into the ring now. From behind. The Viper into the headlock.
Randy Orton another uppercut. Working on the head of Del Rio, which is what he should do. He's going to go for a submission here. Del Rio reaches out, hits the ropes. Orton throwing. Oh! In the scoop slam takedown, an elbow to the face. Right hand. Grapple. Reversal by Del Rio. Reversal again by Orton. Orton is looking at those steel steps. He wants to do something on those steel steps. It kind of looks like SmackDown to me. Oh. Del Rio attacking the arms. Getting the better of Randy Orton there. Kick straight to the back. Oh. A leg roll and Orton throwing Del Rio onto those steps. Oh, he throws him out of the ring. Randy Orton throwing Del Rio into the barrier. What is he going to do here? Headbutt. Randy Orton has been known to sacrifice his own body for the betterment of the match. And oh no. Oh no, they're going to go through the barricade. Through the barricade. Oh my gosh. Randy Orton taking Del Rio down. Randy Orton thinking of winning this match by countout. That would be really dull. Come on, Del Rio. Come on. Get up. Get up. Del Rio is not moving. Del Rio has been knocked out. He is not going to make it. 9 and another AI victory because of a countout. Randy Orton wins the match. Taking Del Rio through the barricade. Look at this match. The reversals. No RKO even hit. No finisher used. Except for going through the barrier. In the aftermath. Leaving Del Rio down. Del Rio cannot believe he just lost. He even had help from the WWE World Champion. Daniel Bryan. Del Rio getting no offense there. Randy Orton winning, even though Daniel Bryan interfered. Is Randy Orton going to go after Daniel Bryan next week? We're going to have to find out. Let's preview some Monday Night Raw.
You think you know me?
Okay, let's see. So no news. We are 2 weeks away from Over the Limit, which will be changed. Hopefully to something, no custom theme. Okay. Okay, well, Over the Limit, I'm not sure what that is. Like, submission matches? I'm not sure. So we'll... Yeah, we'll just kind of... I don't want to change anything then if it's inspired by something. Let's look here. We have David Otunga going up against Santino Marella with Damian Sandow. Look at that. Damian Sandow in the match. We're going to have to play as Sandow there. We've got Eve versus Brie Bella. Nikki Bella the champion, probably at Shenanigans, maybe Twin Magic gonna ensue there and keep Eve away from the championship. We have Rey Mysterio and Kofi Kingston teaming up against Brodus Clay and Primo. What will happen in that tag match? It is a highlight match. It'll be very interesting to see what shenanigans will ensue. Another triple threat match of Zack Ryder, Dolph Ziggler, Jack Swagger. Who is going to win that match? Whoever wins that match is probably going to be the number one contender. And then finally, we do have Brock Lesnar going up against R-Truth. Again in the main event, Brock Lesnar's done this before. He has taken out Triple H before in the very same fashion. What will happen on Monday Night Raw? Well, you're going to have to find out because this video is over. See, we still have CM Punk to get involved here. Kane, Chris Jericho, and Cena, Edge. Who else isn't really involved? Okay. We don't have Stone Cold. We don't have Mankind. We don't have Old School John Cena. These are the people I kind of want to get involved here. Mark Henry hasn't shown up. Wade Barrett has, but not too much. JBL should show up soon. Oh man, SmackDown's just full of people. John Laurinaitis. So we still have some work to do to get other people involved. Thank you for watching the video. Go ahead, like, favorite, comment, subscribe. Do what you gotta do. And we will see you for Monday Night Raw.